First selection was St. Petersburg March, composed by Johnny Benson, which attempts to capture the spirit of the great city of St. Petersburg, Russia. Written in minor keys and melodies harmonized in sixth, this piece paints a musical picture of rigid winters, magnificent castles, and grand cathedrals. In the trio section, two Russian folk songs, Tsar Nikolai and Gori, are quoted in the music.
We will be playing Encanto, which in Spanish means charm, is our next piece. You will hear a vast fanfare played at the beginning, echoed by the full ensemble. Then you will hear an energetic melody that is introduced and developed throughout the overture. We hope you enjoy Encanto.
Thank you. pilot, you join the ranks of those less bound by conventional limits on time, distance, and personal freedom. You take off to wide open skies in any direction on the compass. But more than that, it's freedom as you've never known it, far from the commonplace. Finally, being a pilot symbolizes individualism and self-reliance. You are in control, and you make the choices. There's nothing like the experience of flight, except possibly the experience of music. And I hope the enthusiasm of both can be found in this piece.
In 2019, the start of my third year, we upgraded our ensembles in the classroom to level-based ensembles and experience-based ensembles. And on Friday, this past Friday, those two ensembles premiered at their very first actual festival separately. Usually when we take those trips, we merge the freshman band is what it was with the upper-class band. Students weren't necessarily in the ensembles that where they could be the most successful. This group was one point away from a superior on their first ever festival. It was one of the best performances I've ever heard from this group. And you know, our hope is what we build in this ensemble then trickles into the wind ensemble in each year. Both of our bands get better. And that positively impacts our jazz band, it positively impacts our marching band, and any other groups that we have moving forward. So I just wanted to thank you for your support, because them practicing makes a huge difference. And I know it's not always easy to have an instrument playing in your home, or getting them here on time when you've had a long day at work. So we really appreciate that. We really appreciate all that they've done as well. So we don't have any seniors in this group to recognize, but I did want to make sure that they got their recognition. So thank you. Surgery on the chimes for the second time in 2 days. I do have a senior in this group, and I'm very heartbroken that he's a senior, because he's a beginner this year. He's literally never played an instrument until this year, and I probably did not mark him in the program because I don't want him to go anywhere. Elijah Tamayo, please stand up and be recognized. I very much apologize. Keep him another year, I'd be happy to keep him. Thank you. He's been fabulous. He's playing first trumpet on a lot of our pieces as well. I've been very impressed. And so thank you, Elijah, for being a part of this for this year. ensemble is the jazz band who meets once a week. We played for the Earth Day event at the Bloomfield Library this year, and we played for townwide as well. This is our final performance of the year. We have a mixed group here of freshmen through seniors. Our two seniors on tenor sax in the front row here, I'll go ahead and recognize now, they'll be soloing later, Jordan Furtado and Jacob Garcia. You guys could stand here. Qualities of the jazz ensemble, and this goes along with my philosophy of teaching, is I allow anyone who plays any instrument into jazz band. We work on music that allows flutes, we work on music if someone wanted to play the French horn. So the students don't have to necessarily learn another instrument and still be a part of the culture of playing jazz music. And you're also going to hear some pieces today that maybe you didn't realize were fundamentally jazz. Jazz isn't just swing. You're going to hear some rock, you're going to hear some Latin, what else, salsa. Yes? Yeah, fusion. You're going to hear lots of different variety, which we pride ourselves on here at Bloomfield. So we hope you enjoy the four pieces. I will not introduce them. You should be able to see those in your program. We will have some trumpet solos and ballad for a blue horn as well. So we'll make sure he gets recognized after that. Thank you.
Thank you. so much for that. Thank you. Good evening, everyone. So for our next selection, At Dawn, They Slept, was composed by Jay Wilcook in 2002 and premiered at Pearl Harbor, Hawaii in April 2 by the York, South Carolina High School Band. This work starts softly depicting the presence of the U.S. military at Pearl Harbor in the days preceding December 7, 1941. The main theme will be introduced in the clarinet, show the tranquility and beauty of those days in late 1941. Suddenly, the mood changes at early dawn on December 7th. A distant bugler and soft alarm clocks are noticed. The sounds of approaching planes are heard, and then the chimes sound seven notes, representing the attack at 7 a.m. Next, you will hear the conflict where the percussion, brass, and woodwinds battle in angular, dissonant, and fragmented lines. This conflict will climax and change mood again to a feeling of strength and resolve, where you will hear then the main theme again, softly at first, but then by the full ensemble to end the piece.
Thank you.
We do have quite a few seniors that I'd like to recognize in this group. I was just reminiscing, I was in here by myself before the concert, realizing that this group of seniors were my freshmen the year that we had the shutdown. And we lost a lot of that freshman class that year, but these guys stuck it out, and you see the results. And I think that all that hard work and dedication behind the computer screen paid off. So I want to congratulate all of you, not just the seniors, for persevering through one of the toughest times probably in your lifetime. So thank you for that. I'd like to just ask them to stand as I say their name, hopefully correctly. We practiced this before, but it's been a little nerve-wracking tonight with the other things going on. In the flute section, Gentleman Swan. Clarinet, Gordon Furtado. Nasir Turan. Louis Luque. Tenor saxophone, Jacob Garcia. Joshua Robinson. Trumpet section, Sebastian Molsky. Skylar Crawley. Euphonium, Layla Camacho. And last but not least, in our percussion section, Zeri Tumama. With this ensemble. I reminded them of that this morning. I get to do this every year, which is a pleasure for me, but I just want everybody to remember when you walk off the stage that you should be super proud of everything that you've done over the last 4 years, 3 years, 2 years, however many years you've been in the program. This will be, I tell them this every year, it's a new ensemble every year. We have to work to adjust to each other. I'm thoroughly impressed with this group. We went to our first festival on Friday as well. They got superior ratings from both judges, even with me making some mistakes myself and some mishaps and some of the percussion instruments, we still were able to make everything work, and I'm very, very proud of them for their professionalism. Both groups were commented on their professionalism, which is a big deal. We pride ourselves on that. So I hope you enjoy the last two pieces that they're performing. You will hear some solos in this next piece, and then we have a nice Spanish march for you at the end.
Was commissioned by the Normal Community West High School Band of Normal, Illinois, Lisa Preston, director. The piece was written in 1996 and premiered in April of that year with the composer conducting. It is based on the composer's impressions of three poems found in the collection of 18th century Irish ballads, and is written as a tribute to the wonderful music of Granger Holst and Vaughan Williams. This piece was one of the most challenging pieces we worked on this year and will feature several soloists throughout. Please hold your applause until all three movements are complete. Thank you.
her final selection tonight is Amparito Roca. This Spanish Pasa Doble March was written by Spanish bandleader and composer Jaime Tetador. The introduction and first string are indicative of a bullfighter's music, whereas the gentle, lighthearted trio section takes on the character of a couple's dance, evoking the other essential element of a Pasa Doble. The powerful brass in the dogfight, or bullfight, and the 2D set texture of the Maestoso section bring this piece to a grand conclusion. Thank you all for attending our spring concert and our concert of the year. And from all the seniors here, I want to thank you for your support for all of our ensembles throughout all these years. Thank you.
Students, there are refreshments for you downstairs in the cafeteria, and we're going to take everything back to the room, not tonight, so make sure you show up to school the next 2 days, okay? Thank you. Have a great night. Thank you for a great year.